So I've been frequently asked what programs are good to use to make sub badges or emotes for your Twitch channel. And well, in this video, I'm actually going to show you that if you have an iPad, you already have access to a pretty great art program. So welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Oasis and I'm going to teach you about art. You can watch me draw live every Monday and Thursday at 8 p.m. Pacific. You can also join the Discord if you have any questions that you need to ask off stream. And make sure you come back and hit that subscribe and that like button down there. You can come back and learn some more. So before, we talked about the general idea about how to make an emote from scratch in Photoshop on your computer. I was using a Wacom tablet, or Wacom, however you want to pronounce it. And in this video, I'm actually going to use an iPad to create an emote from scratch. So it really doesn't matter how you start out your process. I usually start using a sketch, and I like making my sketches look like they've been sketched in pencil. That's just personal preference. You can use a softer brush if you like, and you can be a lot less finicky and detailed as I am doing. On stream, a lot of the times I'm just kind of being distracted, and so I am erasing more than necessary and cleaning up the sketch, because a lot of the times when I'm working with clients, I want to have a nice clean sketch so they can see what the emote or badge is going to look like without any color or line or anything. And so I just get into a habit of doing that, but you don't necessarily have to do that. You can make it messier and then clean it up as you go to your lining process. So I'm cleaning it up probably more than I need to, and then I realized that the eyes are just kind of a little small, so I'm actually going to be resizing the eyes. There's a tool at the top of ProCreate that allows you to create a selection so you can circle around the things that you need to, and then you can go ahead and resize whatever you need to. So that's what I did there. And then again, I'm just cleaning up the sketch just to pass some time. Not really necessary to do all this. I think I was just making sure that I had all the size right, so that when I go over it with my inking, it's where I need to and I don't have to do as much editing during the inking phase. So that's usually a lot of what I do, is that I just make sure that it looks clean before I start to ink. And then I go in and use usually a nice smooth brush. Sometimes you can get one with a tapered edge, it doesn't really matter. But in ProCreate, there's a lot of different options. You can also find people that make brushes. I haven't quite figured out how to make my own brushes yet, so that is not something that I offer. This is all, I am just using all of the default brushes that are available in the program when you first get it. But there's always people selling them or having them available somewhere around on the internet. And there's a lot of different options. This is a basic round soft brush that I just decided to use on the outline. And I think it looks pretty nice, actually. Now, I did speed everything up, as you can kind of imagine. I'm not really drawing it this quick, but I do draw fairly quickly anyway. So you just have to clean it all up and decide what you like. And what I'm actually going to do at the end of this video, after I've cleaned all this up, is that I'm going to put this emote, it's a base emote, and I'm going to slap it up on my Discord, and you can grab the emote itself and use it for coloring or testing or just trying whatever you can to try to make your own emotes. You can tweak it and edit it if you would like. I would love that. It's completely for free as long as you credit back to me as the person that created it. Maybe it will help you in your pursuits in learning how to make different emotes. This is just me just messing around. Not sure if I wanted to have that thing in the back of the throat. I decided against it. But that's pretty much all I have right now for this particular emote. I think for now you can kind of see that any basic art program can be used to make emotes, even ProCreate. You can do Photoshop. I can show you how to do an emote in Affinity Photo, which is what I've been using a lot right now, actually. So I would definitely recommend, if you have anything else There's also plenty of free programs and cheap programs too. So ProCreate is cheap, even if you don't have an iPad, obviously. iPads are expensive, but the ProCreate is very inexpensive. And it's a great art program. You can save them as transparencies, as a PNG, and then you have an awesome emote. So come over to my Discord, see me draw live again on Twitch, and hopefully we will see you again soon. Thanks so much for being here, and have a good one. Adieu. One of us.